are you people? Why can't I take it off? Where am I?
Let's just try to calm down.
The Amazing Digital Circus has amassed over 200 million views and 5 million likes since the pilot episode premiered a few months ago. The series is off to a great start with a single episode and much acclaim. Fans of the Digital Circus eagerly await the release of the next installment, creating fanworks and theories to bide their time. Some of them have taken to Tumblr, where the creator of the series, Gooseworx, has an account and occasionally answers questions about Pomni and her fellow characters. Although Gooseworx is purposefully vague about what will happen in future installments, some of the information provided and their tasks can point us in the right direction for some of our theories. That's why, in today's video, we're considering what could happen in the second episode of The Digital Circus.
This is where your living quarters are, as well as all sorts of other activities! These activities may include...
Number 1. A new character. When the first episode premiered, it introduced a unique and engaging cast of main characters. Pomni is the main character and the latest human trapped in the circus, while Kane is the AI ringmaster. Their companions include humans trapped in the circus for years, including Jax, Ragatha, Gangle, Zubul, and Kinger. The first episode does a fantastic job establishing these characters, their dynamics with one another, and their personalities. For example, Jax falls into the trickster archetype, while Ragatha is more of a compassionate caregiver. Fans are eager to see more of these characters, especially because many of them have already become fan favorites in such a short amount of time. Therefore, it's no surprise that a Tumblr user asked Gooseworx if episodes would have dedicated stories for each character. Gooseworx responded that with a complete season, every character should get their own little episode. Naturally, fans expected these episodes to center around the characters introduced in the pilot. However, Gooseworx gave a curveball when another user asked which character the second episode would be about by stating it was for a character the audience hasn't met yet. If Gooseworx is honest with these answers, we can discern that the second episode will introduce a new character. Oddly enough, the theme song for the first episode includes everyone who currently lives in the circus. There's even a placeholder for Kofmo, who didn't attend to be a part of the sequence. When Pomni arrives at the circus afterward, Jax expresses dismay at the need to do the theme song again if she is an actual person and not an NPC. When a user tasks Gooseworx with describing the following episodes with a single word, the word for the second episode was boy. Assumedly, the character the audience hasn't met is male, and he hasn't joined the circus yet. It's possible that he may be a new human arriving after Pomni, or an NPC introduced by Kane to keep an eye on the other characters.
Kane, is this one of your NPCs, or is this a new sucker? 'Cause if it's a new character...
Number 2. Pomni learns more about the circus. The first episode of The Digital Circus follows Pomni when she joins the virtual world. She has no memory of her life outside the circus, including her name, and she learns she has no opportunity to escape. Pomni's first day at the circus includes an introduction to her fellow humans, and she quickly befriends Ragatha, the most welcoming of the group. Pomni also learns some of the facets of the circus, like how Kane controls most of it, how they have daily adventures to keep their mind sharp, and that they're only permitted to travel through a handful of areas. Unfortunately, the information the audience and Pomni learn about the circus is simple. Humans become trapped there when they put on a virtual headset and they don't know how to escape, and they go about their daily lives trying to keep themselves from going insane. It seems like the other characters have lived in the circus for so long that they care more about surviving than learning the truth. But as the newest addition to the circus, Pomni may have the drive to uncover secrets Kane would rather keep hidden. There are many things that Pomni could uncover, including who made the digital circus, and the answer may be inside the exit rooms from the pilot. In the first episode, Pomni tries to escape using an exit door, but instead of waking up in the real world, she finds herself trapped in a maze of an office building, only finding the void on the other side. The office building included an old computer, a VR headset, and a company logo that read CNA. Kane later states that he made the exit doors but didn't know what to put on the other side of them, meaning the extent of his knowledge of the world could begin and end with the company that produced the digital circus.
I do have to apologize for lying about the exit.
Number 3. The appearance of a new room. One of the more intriguing components of the circus is that every human receives a bedroom despite not needing to sleep or rest. These bedrooms exist inside the main tent of the circus, where events like daily adventures also take place. Kane likely made the bedrooms to give the humans a sense of normalcy and a calm place to retire at the end of the day. However, the rooms are peculiar. In the pilot episode, Ragatha and Jax take Pomni down the long hallway of bedrooms, where some doors have faces marked out with an X. These X's indicate that the rooms of every abstraction victim remain intact. The only bedroom shown in the pilot belongs to Kofmo and has signs of his abstraction within it. The walls contain messages about Kane, the exits, and Kofmo's desire to leave the circus. If we ignore the messages left by Kofmo, his bedroom's design reflects his altered appearance, including images of clowns and objects often used during a clown's act. It's likely that the other characters' rooms also mimic their appearance, meaning that Ragatha's room may contain doll-like figures, or Kinger's room will pertain to chess. A Tumblr user asked Gooseworx if we would get to see inside every character's room, and the answer was a simple eventually. It's unclear if every room will appear in the series or through concept art, but by the second episode, Pomni should have the opportunity to view her new room. The pilot episode also foreshadows the appearance of new rooms in the future, as Jax reveals himself to have a key ring and access to all the bedrooms.
Where we all sleep at night. Even though we don't really need to sleep, it's sometimes nice to kind of take a break from everything.
Number 4. More about Kane. Although the entire series is shrouded in mystery, the character with the most intrigue is the artificial intelligence that runs the show, Kane. As the ringmaster, he appears to be the closest thing that the digital circus has to an antagonist. However, if Kane turns out to be the big bad of the series, he does a remarkable job of throwing Pomni and the other humans off his trail. During the pilot, Kane does seem to care for the humans. He creates adventures to ward off boredom and keep their minds sharp, fixes them when they encounter obstructions, and gives rewards for completing their daily tasks. He's optimistic, and his can-do attitude makes him easy to trust, which explains why Pomni immediately searches for him when asked. Unfortunately, Kane isn't the kind leader he appears to be. For starters, he knows more than he's letting on. Kofmo becomes abstracted because he's told there are no exit doors in the circus, and Kane tries to tell Pomni the same thing. However, he admits to creating them when caught in the lie, meaning he's responsible for Kofmo's abstraction. He also claims that if Pomni strays further into the void, meaning he has plans for the circus that he and the series haven't yet revealed.
I assure you, there is no magical exit door.
Number 5. Exploring the setting. Since the digital circus takes place in a virtual world, it makes sense for the setting to be limited to a small space. During the pilot, Pomni spends her time between the tent, the exit doors, and the void. The tent alone has numerous rooms and doors to explore, containing liminal spaces that include bathrooms, carousels, and restaurants. Kane may have created these locations to give himself and the humans things to do. They are likely some of the projects he mentioned at the end of the episode. However, the tent isn't the only location for Pomni to explore. When she first arrives at the circus, Kane gives her a tour of the grounds and tells her where she can venture. Aside from the tent, there's a lake and a carnival, and the second episode could dedicate time to Pomni and the others exploring them.
Drown yourself in the digital lake or engage in ridery at the digital carnival!
According to Gooseworx's Tumblr, the Amazing Digital Circus will follow a specific narrative structure. If the series has a complete first season, then every character will have an episode centered around them, their rooms explored, and many episodes will leave us questioning what happened. For a psychological dark comedy, The Amazing Digital Circus is setting the stage to become one of the most engaging, entertaining, and most talked about online series. If the second episode is anything like the first, then it'll be a success.
But where can I find him?
I don't really know.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and turn on notifications to stay updated on our uploads.
Above anything else, the adventures give us something to do that keeps our minds healthy and stimulated.